Hello, and welcome to episode 8 of Let's Play Civilization 6. In our last episode, we had concluded a war with Brazil, taking Rio de Janeiro, and as tribute or capitulation, we got Curitiba as well. I'm actually thinking about just starting a war and taking this next city as well. Might as well. I mean, at this point, the world hates us. Mostly. And there's really no downsides to it at this point, and they're kind of crippled at the moment. And it's a good time to do it. So, they just failed a spy mission, so I'm going to see if I have a casus belli against them. Thus, you promise not to spy on me. Yes, you're right, Ergrid. Well, I hope so. Well, we just denounce them so we can declare war in 5 turns. I think that's how it works. Let me double check that. Well, at least we've taken the lead in score. There's nowhere to see my current deals. I mean, they did grant us a peace treaty, but I don't know how that goes. We'll see. We'll give us some time to heal up our cities here. Well, I'm glad I could help. Oh, their barbarians are attacking. Cancel deal. Yeah. What I find a little bit difficult is without the global happiness system, it's very hard for me to figure out if I have enough luxuries in place, and if, you know, because each luxury will give me 4 amenities, and if I have more than one copy, I get 8. So right now I have more than 4 cities. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 cities. So I need at least, well, if I want some base happiness, 2 copies of each resource, right? 2 copies will give me 1 for each city, and then for the other one, I'll get another 1 for each city. I think that's how it works. But there's, is there a tally bar? I don't see one. View reports, resources. See, I have here. See, the luxury should be its own table. I don't like this. Oh, okay, I see. So, the resources here is telling me the incense is going to Washington. No, actually, no, this is basically where they are found. Not necessarily which city you're getting what resource. City status. Displeased. Well, I can see here on a high level that see which city's happy, which city's unhappy, but I don't. It's, you know, doing the mental math with so many resources and not being sure which one is luxury, which one isn't, is a little bit tedious. I wish it would tell me if I have any extra resources to trade away instead. And used to be there used to be a luxury resource tab up here, so or not a tab, but a general happiness thing here in Civ 5, and I can tab over it and I'll see that which resources is giving me happiness. But here it's a little bit different. I think I can trade away one of something because I'm mostly happy. What's actually the problem right now is I have limited housing. So let's see if I can trade something to the Greeks. Discuss. Okay, they spied on me earlier, so we're just doing that. Big deal. Let's see here. Trade one of these away. And I wanted to go to the Great Works. I'm looting the arts of the Brazilians. Okay. Oh, there's Seoul, so there's at least one more civ I haven't met. Or is Seoul? No, envoy to Seoul means Seoul is a city-state. I've met Brazil, or Brussels. Capitalism. New Orleans. Shield zone, and then I'll also buy a unit. Oh, I had meant to buy a combat engineer, and I forgot. So let me get a builder here, and then buy a combat engineer or military engineer. And I see that I can now upgrade my cannons to artillery, which is going to be awesome. Oh no, I can't. Is artillery a separate unit that's not the same as. Yeah, there's no upgrade path for that. Artillery. It's a separate unit I have to build. Okay. Just leave it at that for now. Wow, look at all these catapults from Brussels. One of the things I did here on the forums, and this seems to be always a problem with a vanilla, like the very first release of a Civ game, is the AI will have trouble upgrading its units. It happened in Civ 3, I think it happened in Civ 4, and it happened in Civ 5 as well. The AI would be playing in a late game with, like, warriors with clubs, and eventually it'll get fixed, but I'm wondering what kind of code is causing it to do that. I assume they're just being overly cautious about it and not telling the AI to upgrade, but actually I think they're making the AI weaker than it should be by being really cautious about upgrades. I assume it's an economic issue, like the AI doesn't have enough money to do it, and they haven't made the proper adjustments to the AI in terms of maybe buffing it, giving it discounts, or something like that. It's just something interesting to think about. Get another great person. Okay, I'll get another great general. I'll take it. Let's get a artillery out there. Get a shipyard. Okay, combat engineer, or military engineer, lets me build roads. I have two charges. Guess I'll build a road between New Orleans and Rio. That might help. General, I'll move this general up here. Okay. Now this builder, I wanted to build some farm. Well, these are ruins here, that's gonna help me later, but... nothing right now. To build factories once I complete industrialization.
I think the human race made a big mistake at the beginning of the Industrial Revolution. We leaped for the mechanical things. People need the use of their hands to feel creative.
Let's go for chemistry. I'm going to build a cluster of farms here for food. Buy another builder here. She let me buy an artillery. And I'm gonna buy a builder here. Oh, I can't because I have something in here. Oh no, because I already bought something, I think. So I'll save that and do that next turn. Okay.
Improved. The whole palace complex is built along a central axis, the axis of the world. Everything in the four directions suspend from this central point, represented by these palaces. Improvement makes straight roads, but the crooked roads without improvements are roads of genius.
Go here. And get the factory going. Oh, right, we get a new wild card slot, so I can sign something. Let's do that. I just did to do this. I don't know why I'm being asked to do this again. Jeez, that's a huge artillery piece there. Oh, only two builds for a military engineer. It's a little bit disappointing. No, I don't know why this thing is moving over here. I didn't mean to send him all the way out there. Met another city-state. Aerodrome. Okay, well, I'll have to wait. What is his passive ability? Actually, I could start using this guy now, right? Modern, no, I'll save him for a bit longer. Actually, not a great ability. Plus one level of diplomatic visibility with all other civilizations. So I guess I could see more with them. I might as well use it. Oh, they got Oxford right here. It's good timing to take that city there, too.
Chemists do not usually stutter. It would be very awkward if they did, seeing that they have times to get out such words as methyl ethyl amylo phenelium.
Is that meth? Where's my other great general? Okay, same boss as the other great general. So I'll keep this one here. That's bugged out, the influence page. Thank you. See here if I can start another war with this guy. You know what? Let's do it. Yeah? You think so?
Você verá como lhe será infrutífero.
Okay, well, India doesn't like me. This artillery is insane, the amount of damage it just did in one volley. Oh, we're getting truffle, so that's good. And more spices. Are these luxuries? Yes, pearls. So I want to swing by Guarul Holes. I'll get all this stuff here. And I'll also kind of link up. Slowly but surely we're linking up to the city-state that we want to be friends with up here. What is he doing up here? See, that's the thing I have a problem with the UI is when you run out of movement points for one unit, it'll cut immediately over to the next unit and you might be thinking you're still moving that last unit. Oh, Congo doesn't like me. And yeah, I end up moving things to places where I didn't think they would be going, and that's kind of really weird. Oh wow, they've got battleships.
You and I come by road or rail, but economists travel on infrastructure.
I lost one of my cannons here. Okay, I think this is a good place to stop the video. Thank you for watching. I will see you next time.